Hello boys, welcome back to another session of video tutorials. This session is meant for class 11th biology students and this is meant for 12th August 2020. If we recollect from our memory, we understand that we were discussing, reflecting upon and making a concept of the chapter photosynthesis. In our previous chapter, previous session, we were talking about C3 plants and C4 plants. And in particular, we were talking about in C4 plants, the Hatch-Slack pathway, how exactly carbon dioxide gets fixed. And if you remember, I said that whether it is C3 or C4, Kelvin cycle participation is a must. Now, in overall photosynthesis, if you see, will there be any factors that affect photosynthesis, be it in C3 plants or C4 plants? So there is a law of limiting factors, a scientist by name Blackmans. Remember Blackmans, that is dark phase 1905. What does he say? If a chemical process is affected by more than one factor, then its rate will be determined by the factor which is nearest to its minimal value. So normally we say the factor which has got high influence will decide the rate of reaction or the amount of products that are formed. But Blackman said it is the nearest to the normal value. It is the factor which directly affects the process if its quantity is changed. The moment we change the value, that is minimum, the whole process gets affected. That's what Blackman's law of limiting factors. So, as all of us know, when we wrote photosynthesis, remember we wrote CO2 plus H2O. These are the two raw materials we require. And this fellow has taken place in light reaction, Hillman reaction or light phase. Photolysis has taken place, the H2O is broken, H plus and OH minus formed. So we discussed what is the fate of that electrons that are formed. We also discussed what is the fate of that proton H plus that is formed. And the CO2 plays a crucial role in dark phase, that Blackman's reaction. And CO2 gets reduced to starch by protons H plus. And the CO2 becomes starch through Kelvin cycle. And for this to happen, both in light reaction and dark reaction, H2O is a must, CO2 is a must. So these are the two factors must be there in photosynthesis. And this happens, you know, when there is sunlight. Sunlight is a must. And also, you know, within the plant there should be chlorophyll. Then you get starch. Starch will be formed. So at least four factors must be there which will decide the photosynthesis, rate of photosynthesis, the entire process of photosynthesis. What are those? First, sunlight. Without sunlight, there is no question of photosynthesis. Second, for the sunlight to be absorbed, there must be a pigment, green color pigment, chlorophyll A, chlorophyll B. We talked about light harvesting system. We talked about PS1, PS2, and we said 700 nanometers. And who is observing that 700 nanometers, 680 nanometers? It is the chlorophyll. So chlorophyll is a must and sunlight should be there. And in their presence, the H2O should split, light reaction should take place, then followed by dark reaction, then only you get starch. So what these four will decide how exactly the photosynthesis takes place. So at low light intensity, at low intensities of light, there is a linear relationship between incident light and carbon fixation. When the intensity of light is very low, rate of photosynthesis is reduced. Suppose 680, 7 nanometer, below that if it is there, naturally rate of photosynthesis will come down. At high intensities of light also, the rate does not show further increase because other factors become limiting factors. This is what Blackman's law of limiting factors. So there is a point in light intensity where there is no gaseous exchange in photosynthesis. It is called light compensation point. The light intensity at which a plant can achieve maximum rate of photosynthesis is called light saturation point. Its value is 800 to 1000 fit candles 10% of full sunlight. In shade plants, 50 to 70% of full sunlight in C3 sun plants. So this is how the light will decide the rate of photosynthesis. Increase in incident light beyond a point results in breakdown of chlorophyll because it gets denatured and decreases photosynthesis. Now we come to the second one, CO2, carbon dioxide concentration. And you can put a graph of graphical representation, the influence of carbon dioxide. On x-axis you can have CO2 concentration, okay? On y-axis you can have the rate of photosynthesis, you can say, okay, rate of photosynthesis. So when you plot the graph, you get something like this, you know. It is there in the textbook, you can follow that. So C3 plants and C4 plants, you can have different graphs. So increase in the concentration of carbon dioxide up to 0.05% increases the rate of photosynthesis. So the CO2 is up to 0.05%, then rate of photosynthesis will be up. And in most C3 plants, this happens. But a decline is observed beyond 0.1%. So 0.5% is good. When carbon dioxide concentration is reduced, there comes a point at which illuminated plant parts stop absorbing CO2 from their environment. It is known as carbon dioxide compensation point or threshold value. At this value, carbon dioxide fixed in photosynthesis is equal to carbon dioxide evolved in respiration and photorespiration. So the value is 25 to 100 ppm parts per million in C3 plants and 0 to 10 ppm in C4 plants. So you can represent this in the form of a graph, carbon dioxide. And we go to the third factor, temperature. You know, when the temperature is optimum, all the enzymes will work. At high temperatures or low temperatures, enzyme gets denatured. They will not work. So the dark reactions are controlled by temperature because they are enzymatic. You have seen so many enzymes were present in Kelvin cycle also. Light reactions are also sensitive to temperature, but to a much lesser extent. C4 plants have much higher temperature optimum than C3 because of cryogenic. The temperature optimum for a particular plant also depends on its natural habitat. Tropical plants have higher temperature optimum than temperate plants. So something like, you know, temperature does not influence photochemical phase of the photosynthesis light reaction, but it affects the dark reaction. The optimum temperature is 10 to 25 degrees centigrade in C3 plants and 30 to 45 degrees in C4 plants. When temperature is increased from minimum to optimum, the rate of photosynthesis doubles for every 10 degrees rise in temperature. Above the optimum temperature, the rate of photosynthesis shows an initial increase for short duration, but later declines. Again, when you put a graph, it's something like it goes up and then decline. So you can plot a graph. This is called time factor. And we come to the fourth one, most important one. Without this, no photosynthesis at all. Water, fourth factor. The effect of water is more on the plant rather than directly on photosynthesis. Water stress results in closing of stomata and thus reduced availability of CO2. So they are directly linked. Opening and closing of stomata is linked with water stress, and CO2 intake will be affected. Water stress also leads to folding of leaves. Wilting of leaves means reduced surface when it gets folded and reduced metabolic activity in leaves. So water is a must. The amount of water used in photosynthesis, though, you must know, is less than 1%. The rate of photosynthesis falls in water deficient soils. During excessive transpiration, the stomata gets closed. This results in the fall in the rate of photosynthesis because CO2 cannot enter through cuticle of the leaf. Now comes the last one, I will put it as fifth one, oxygen itself. Small quantity of oxygen is essential for photosynthesis. This may surprise you, except in some anaerobic bacteria. C3 plants show optimum photosynthesis in low oxygen levels, when oxygen levels are low. It is due to reason that oxygen results in oxidation of photosynthetic pigments, intermediates and enzymes in the presence of strong light, photooxidation. Oxygen competes with carbon dioxide for reducing power reduction. It also converts, you know, RuBP Rubisco to RuBP oxygenase. At a very high oxygen content, the rate of photosynthesis begins to decline in plants. This phenomenon is called Warburg effect, only for competitive exam's sake. Warburg, W-A-R-B-U-R-G, Warburg effect, this, okay? This is for, not for your exam's sake, for competitive exam's sake. And these are the five external factors. What about internal factors? Chlorophyll content, that will decide, no? How much rate of photosynthesis, age of the leaf also will decide, and anatomy of the leaf also will decide. These are the three internal factors that will decide the rate of photosynthesis, particularly Krang's anatomy, special anatomy such